you. Hi, guys. Sorry.
Hey. There's my, people here.
We're my class. Sorry.
So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 people in the audience, teacher. Did you say, oh, crap?
No, I said, all right. I should have said, oh, crap, though. Okay. Good morning, everybody. So my speech is something that I feel very passionate about. It's a little bit emotional, but I'm just going to get started. So my brother Trenton turned 16 on May 4th, 2017, and on May 15th, 2017, he was in a car accident that took his life. So he was not wearing a seatbelt. He was ejected from the vehicle and killed on impact. So today I'm going to be talking to you about seatbelt safety, car seat safety, and how to avoid distracted driving, and why all of these things are so important. So my nephew, Bo, was 3 at the time, and he's now 5 years old. He was in the back seat of the same car that my brother was in, and he was buckled in the car seat correctly. This saved his life. The driver of the car was under the influence of drugs. That is the reason that this car accident happened. He drove off the road, the car flipped, and went from there. So many people die from car accidents each year. Every day, a lot of people lose their lives. A lot of people choose not to wear seatbelts in the car. A lot of parents are reckless with car seat safety. They don't understand how important it is to get knowledge on car seat safety. And I see a lot of people on their phones when they're driving. I don't know about any of you, but when I'm just driving down the road and I look out my window, I see people texting or people talking on the phone all the time. So it's ridiculous. You can just look and notice these things. So as a kid, I was never really pushed to wear a seatbelt. I never really realized how important it was or if it would be life or death one day. We had a dog that chewed all the seatbelts out of our car. We left her in the car for maybe 2 minutes, ran to the gas station, came back. All of our seatbelts were chewed of that car. So now we didn't have the money to have them replaced, so we drove without seatbelts. And this was like 2008, I think. Wasn't a huge deal to us then. We didn't realize the consequences that could have came from that. So today I'm going to be talking about why it's important to wear seatbelts, why it's important to gain knowledge on car seat safety, and why it's important to drive sober and with no distractions. So I'm going to begin with the main problems of this. A total of 23,714 people die each year from car accidents. That is insane. This was the number from 2016, and it's growing from there. And more than half of those deaths were from not being buckled up while they were driving. So more than half, if you just think about that for a second, that's a lot of people that weren't wearing a seatbelt and frankly lost their lives from that. So a few reasons, like, you're probably thinking, okay, well, why should we wear a seatbelt? Why is it so important? Well, first off, it's the law. You could pay pretty expensive fines for not wearing your seatbelt, and to me, that's not worth it. I would rather buy other things than have to pay a fine for just not putting on a seatbelt. And a lot of people say, oh, well, I don't wear my seatbelt because the airbag is there to protect me. Or the steering wheel is there to protect me in case I was in a crash. Yes, to an extent, but did you know that the airbags were actually designed to work with seatbelts and not just alone? That's their main purpose, is to work with seatbelts, not just on their own. Seatbelts promote safety. They prevent you from hitting the windshield. They prevent you from being ejected from the vehicle. So with a seatbelt and an airbag, it's going to do the most protection there. They are the best defense against road hazards. So really bumpy roads, you're kind of throwing yourself all around. If you have your seatbelt on, it's not as bad. It protects you against distracted drivers. I know it doesn't do a lot, but it does more protection than if you weren't wearing your seatbelt. So now I'm going to get into car seat safety. And this is a big deal to me because I have a 10-month-old son, so I take a lot of pride in this. Motor vehicle injuries are the number one cause of death in young children in the United States. That's the leading cause. Buckling children in age and size appropriate car seats, booster seats, and seat belts is very important, and it reduces serious and fatal injuries by 80%. 80%, you guys, that's insane. So in order to keep your children safe in the car seat, you have to make sure you find a car seat that's proper fitting, it's the correct type, it's installed correctly, and you need to make sure your child is safe when they're in that car seat. As children get older, they think it's funny or cool when they can unbuckle themselves. They do that when you're driving. That could be really bad if you were to get in an accident or make any sort of sudden stops. There are different types of car seats. So right now my son is in a rear-facing car seat. That is from birth to age 2 by law, but it's actually recommended by the American Academy of to rear-face until your child has outgrown the weight and height limit on that car seat. So my son, his car seat has a 50-pound weight limit for rear-facing, and right now he's only 24 pounds, so he still has a long way to go in that seat. And then forward-facing, it's the same. So once your child, my child, will reach 50 pounds, he will be flipped to forward-facing, and then he will be forward-facing until he reaches the weight limit for that. Then he will switch to a booster seat until he is 4'9" tall to keep him safe. Now with distracted driving, each day in the United States, 9 people are killed because of distracted driving, and those cause accidents, and more than 1,000 people are injured each day because of distracted drivers. And with alcohol impaired driving, 29 people die every day with crashes related to alcohol impaired drivers. 29 people. That's too high. I feel like that's too high. There are different types of distractions when you're driving. There is the visual, manual, and cognitive. So visual, you just don't take your eyes off the road, don't look at your phone, don't look at anything else. Manual, don't take your hands off the wheel. Don't even think about it. And then cognitive, don't take your mind off of driving. That is very important. So now that you've heard the facts, some of them are pretty scary facts, it's time for the easy solutions. The first one, wear a seatbelt. That's very important, and it's a pretty easy solution. Every car comes equipped with them. Did you guys know that? Every car has one. And if you wear your seatbelt, you are reducing serious injuries and death by half. So like I said earlier, airbags, yes, they help, but they provide the most protection when they're paired with a seatbelt. And proper car seat use. Proper installation is key. A lot of people say, oh, I don't understand how to properly install a car seat. Well, there's this thing, it's an instruction manual. It comes with a lot of things that we buy. Cell phones have instruction manuals. Toasters have instruction manuals. Your car seat also has one. On the front, it says, read this instruction manual. Do not install or use this child restraint until you read and understand the instructions in this manual. Failure to properly use this child restraint increases the risk of serious injury or death in a sudden stop or crash. Right on the front, I didn't even open anything. That's what it says right there on the front. And a lot of people don't read these. I have read this, how to install, you know, the car seat correctly, because it's very important. A lot of people don't understand. You know, when you wiggle your car seat, it's not supposed to move more than an inch. A lot of people don't know that. And, you know, you get on YouTube, if you're looking for some help, like, how do I install this car seat? I have no idea. There are thousands of videos on YouTube telling you, okay, well, here's step-by-step instructions. You just have to find your resources. You don't take advantage of those resources. And you make sure that your child is fitting properly in that seat to make sure they stay safe. You know, the chest clip is supposed to be at chest level. It's called a chest clip, so it's at chest level, not at your belly button or anything like that. No extra accessories in the car seat. I know they sell extra stuff that's really cute, but it's actually not safe. And stores still get away with selling them, even though they're not safe or recommended. And with distracted driving, this one's also a very easy solution. Don't look at your phone. You know, if you are to be, you are drinking, just don't drive. Call an Uber. There's a lot of options with that. You can turn your cell phone off while you drive. You can call an Uber, have a friend take you. There's a lot of other options than getting behind the wheel while you're drunk or any sort of impairment or things like that. So now that you understand how easy it is to be safer in the car and to avoid these scary things, you know, here's the benefits again. Seatbelts will keep you safer in the vehicle. Car seats can save your kid's life, and choosing to drive sober with no distractions could save your life and the surrounding driver's lives as well. So as my speech is coming to a close, I hope you all realize the scary facts and statistics that come with these things, not wearing a seatbelt, and I hope that we all can decide to be safer drivers and passengers. So just by a show of hands, can I just see anybody who will wear their seatbelt the next time they get in the car? Anybody? Thank you.